أكبر كبيرا
الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd.
Allahu Akbar kabira, walhamdulillahi kathira, wa subhanallahi bukratan wa asila. La ilaha illallah wahdah, sadaqa wa'dah, wa nasara 'abdah, wa a'azza jundahu wa hazama al-ahzaba wahdah. La ilaha illallah, wa la na'budu illa iyyah, mukhlisina lahu ad-din wa law kariha al-kafirun. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar kabira, walhamdulillahi kathira, wa subhanallahi bukratan wa asila. La ilaha illallah wahdah, sadaqa wa'dah, wa nasara 'abdah, wa a'azza jundahu wa hazama al-ahzaba wahdah. La ilaha illallah, wa la na'budu illa iyyah, mukhlisina lahu ad-din wa law kariha al-kafirun. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ashabi sayyidina Muhammad wa ala azwaji sayyidina Muhammad wa ala dhurriyyati sayyidina Muhammad wa sallama tasliman katsira.
First of all, I request all the brothers in the prayer hall to stand up and make your rows properly. We can accommodate more brothers who are coming late, inshallah. So I'm requesting all the brothers, please stand up and fill up all of the gaps if you have in front of you or beside you, so we can accommodate more brothers who are coming late, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you guys. So you can sit, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Alhamdulillah wa kafa wa salamun ala ibadihi allazeena astafa. Amma ba'd, qala Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala fi kitabihil kareem. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في مقام آخر: يا أبت افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. فلما أسلم وتله للجبين وناديناه أن يا إبراهيم قد صدقت الرؤيا إنا كذلك نجزي المحسنين. إن هذا لهو البلاء المبين وفديناه بذبح عظيم. صدق الله العظيم. My respected brothers and sisters and my dear children, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has made clear that which is lawful and that which is unlawful. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, none can lead astray. And whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leads astray, none can guide him. I bear witness that there is no worthy of worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and messenger. May the peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon him, his household, his companions, and all those who follow their path. My dear respected brothers and sisters, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the exalted, and always remember your ultimate inevitable return to him. Be aware of the deeds that you have sent forth and do not be deceived by the life of this world. For it is but an illusory enjoyment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, he mentioned in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِي وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. That all who you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he should be feared one, die not except in a state of Islam. Allah says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, as I recited in the beginning, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. That this day I have perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and have chosen for you Islam as your religion. My dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has completed and perfected his deen with complete and comprehensive guidance and regulations. These regulations cover all aspects of human life. In Islam, we can find regulations that cover our aqidah, our beliefs, our ibadat, our behavior, our adat, our ma'amalat, our transactions, which include social, political, and economical dealing, etc. It's no surprise that all these regulations are beneficial to individuals and groups, because the legislator and the guide is our creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who knows what is best for his creation. Allah says in Surah Al-Mulk, أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقْ وَهُوَ اللَّتِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. That should not he who has created know, and he is the most kind and courteous to his slaves, all aware of everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also legislated two Eids for the Muslims, so it can be a season of happiness by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. It is also to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his blessings and bounties that he bestowed upon us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ibrahim, وَآتَاكُم مِّن كُلِّ مَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُ وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. He gave you of all that you asked for. And if you count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, never will you be able to count them. So every nation and every state celebrate festivals of their own. So these celebrations create homogeneity and a collective consciousness that sustains the unity and cohesiveness of a nation. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated to Medina, he found that the people of Medina, the large majority of them, now they become Muslims. They are celebrating two festivals. And they used to play games, compete in sports, and used to have other entertainment. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked them about the significance of these 2 days. So they replied that they celebrated them during the period of Jahiliyyah, the period of ignorance before Islam, and hence they continued with this tradition. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given two better festivals for you, and they are the day of Eid al Adha and day of Eid al Fitr. So alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are celebrating today for this great day of Eid al Adha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send His mercy upon us. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked them about the significance of these 2 days. So they replied that they celebrated them during the period of Jahiliyyah. So they are still continuing to celebrate them. So then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given two better festivals for you and for this nation, which is Eid al-Adha and Eid al-Fitr. So as festivals reflect the beliefs and history of the people, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam changed the custom of the period of ignorance with the Islamic faith identity. So in this respect, he prescribed two festivals that signify Islamic beliefs and culture. So my dear respected brothers, surely from amongst the best deeds and most brilliant acts that bring one close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these days is drawing closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the exalted, by slaughtering the sacrificial animals. And no action of the son of Adam on the day of sacrifice is dearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than sacrificing animals. Indeed, this animal will come on the day of judgment with its horns, hairs and hooves, and indeed the blood of the sacrificial animal is surely accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it falls on the ground. So therefore, my dear respected brothers, do it this act of worship with wholeheartedly. As Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam performed this act of worship, and it was confirmed in the two authentics, Bukhari and Muslim rahimahumullahu ta'ala, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam slaughtered two white horned rams. He slaughtered them with his own hand, and he mentioned Allah's name and takbir, Allahu Akbar. So this is to commemorate the unparalleled sacrifice offered by the Prophet Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, when he, in pursuance to a command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, conveyed him in a dream, prepared himself to slaughter his beloved son, Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. And actually, he did so, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after testing his submission, sent down a sheep and saved his son from the logical fate of slaughter. So it is from that time onwards that the sacrifice of an animal become an obligatory duty to be performed by every well-to-do Muslim. My dear respected brothers, Qurbani is a demonstration of total submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a proof of complete obedience to Allah's will or command. When a believer, a true believer, offers the Qurbani, this is exactly what he intends to prove. Thus the Qurbani offered by a believer signifies that he is a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at his best, and that he would not hesitate even for a moment once he receives an absolute command from his Creator to surrender before it, to obey it willingly, even if we be at the price of his life and possessions. This is exactly what the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam did. Apparently, there was no reason why a father should slaughter his innocent son. But when came the command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he never asked about the reason for that command, nor did he hesitate to follow it. Even his minor son, Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, when asked by his father about the dream he had seen, he never questioned the legitimacy of the command, nor did he pine or whine about it, nor did he ask for one good reason why he was being slaughtered. So the one and only reason he made was, Ya abati f'al ma tu'mar, Satajiduni insha'Allah min as-sabirin. He said, O my beloved father, do what you have been ordered to do. You shall find me inshallah among the patient. So the present day Qurbani is offered in memory of this great model of submission set before us by the great father and the great son, Ismail alayhi salatu wassalam and Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. So Qurbani must be offered in our time, emulating the same ideal and attitude of submission. So my dear respected brothers, on this particular day, we have to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala our complete submission. We have to show Him that we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to take care of His creation. By any means we can do so. We have to ask a question from ourselves. Are our deeds in accordance with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And Allah is going to accept these deeds? Do I find the time to do good? At once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked Sahaba Rizwanullah alayhi majma'in that who among you got up fasting this morning? All the Sahabas were there. So amongst them, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anha stood up and he said, I did. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked again, who among you has attended a funeral today? Again, Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anha said, I have. He asked again, who among you has fed a needy person today? Again, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anha said, I have. He asked again, who among you have visited a sick person today? Again, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anha stood up and he said, I have. The Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no man does all of that, but he will enter paradise. So this kind of behavior we need in this day and age that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from us. So this is the day we have to remember the companions, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and their good deeds, how they used to perform, particularly in these days. So we need to self-evaluate on a constant basis. We need to get enrolled in our community. We need to be known as believer and take part in all our community activities and for those in need. As Muslims, we need to unite as an ummah, make dawah and reach out with the message of Islam. It is our responsibility to share this message of Islam with our non-believer brothers and sisters. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we need to attach our hearts with the believers and express enmity with those that are enemies of Islam. We need to be loyal and sincere to Islam, and we need to care for our brothers in Islam in any and every way we can, even if it is by dua or sharing of your wealth or voicing your opinion. We need to think beyond ourselves and think collectively as an ummah. So let us pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us ability to follow the sunnah of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us our good deeds and bless us on the day of Eid. Let us celebrate Eid to express our intent, gratitude and praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us commit ourselves to the striving, the struggle to bring Allah's choicest gift in the blessed Quran to ourselves and to all humanity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us in our resolve. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. At this point, I would like to request our President Brother Javed Khan, please read the announcement. Jazakumullah.
Thank you, Qari Zamir Chohan, for your words of wisdom, inshallah. And we like to abide by it and try to practice as you said, inshallah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahilhamd. In the name of Allah, the most merciful and the most kind, all praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the only one worthy of worship and none other. And I bear witness that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower his finest blessings upon him and his followers, the Sahaba ikram. Ameen. Respected elders, brothers, sisters, youth, and my dear children, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. On this blessed occasion of Eid al Adha, and on a very humble note, and on behalf of the trustees, the Majlis Shura, the staff, and the volunteers, I am delighted and very happy to welcome you to Islamic Foundation of Toronto. Brothers and sisters, volunteers who are assigned for line collections, I will request you to please raise and pass through the lines for the collection for Eid al Adha. These funds, inshallah, will be used for the day-to-day maintenance of the masjid, utilities, parking lot rentals, and to subsidize the cost of police officers and parking attendants. Please donate generously. Jazakumullah khairan. Alhamdulillah, once again this year, Islamic Foundation of Toronto is honored of being in service to its congregation and the community in ensuring you the comfort to perform your prayers and your religious rituals in tranquility and with ease. Eid al Adha marks the end of Hajj Baitullah, the religious pilgrimage taken by millions of Muslims, marking the true brotherhood without any caste, creed, color, and of any ethnic origin. This is Islam. This is the true spirits of final sermon, the Akhri Hutbah of our dear Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This special day is related to sacrifice and submission, to follow the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to revisit the footsteps of Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, to ponder the brave decision made by him to sacrifice his own son as commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Eid is a joy, Eid is satisfaction to look after the needs of fellow Muslims, to cooperate in the enhancement of good deeds, to build bridges and mercy and sympathy, to achieve the bonds of brotherhood, strengthening firm ties, to establish peace and love amongst us. Let's take as our good ideal the Prophet of Islam, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, to hold firm to his sunnah, his traditions, and the sunnah of a Khulafa'i Rashidin, and to follow the path of the righteous and good ancestors of our Deen Islam. Let's contribute with our good character. Let's build and not destroy. Let's speak the truth and not promote the falsehood. Let's support the good work rather opposing it. Let's believe in the facts and not accommodate any rumors. Let's nurture our love and affection for our parents, our children, our spouses, for the community, and our neighbors and fellow countrymen. Let's not use only the services of this nation, but let's pledge today to volunteer and give back to the community, our society, and Canada, which is our new home and the house of our future children. His message reminds us, let's not forget our brothers and sisters and children in the rest of the world, especially in Burma, Somalia, Kenya, West Africa, Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Guyana, Trinidad, Chechnya, Afghanistan, Iraq, Syria, and most importantly, in the Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala eliminate their distress and the suffering. Ameen. Today, let's open our hearts for them as they are looking towards us with great hope and help and our assistance. A contribution of even a single dollar will bring a priceless smile on their faces. So inshallah, let's pledge today to continue helping our brothers and sisters around the world and benefit for the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Islamic Foundation will be collecting Qurbani meat for the fourth year this year, and the collection will be done Thursdays and Friday this week between 12 noon and 6 p.m. This meat will be distributed to the poor and deserving families within GTA. And you will be happy to know that, alhamdulillah, 300 deserving families benefited from the distribution of meat last year. Please pack your meat in 2 to 3 pounds of polythene bags and drop it in the kitchen located at the lower level. There will be no collection today. New Islamic year calendars are available in the office at a price of $2. Please, on your way out, you can get it or you can pick it up on Friday, inshallah. Finally, I would like to thank Islamic Foundation staff, the volunteers, for their service and dedication towards the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Special thanks to the trustees and the members of the Majlis Ashura for their tireless hour, 365/7/24, in maintaining this center, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We bring you, mashallah, the best programs in GTA Toronto, in not only in different categories, youth tarbiyah conference, qiraat competition, but we also cater to the needs of the Muslim community in educating through religious and academic schools. It is not an easy task, and I will give you my assurance that this Majlis Shura will continue to do that and provide you the best programs in the future, inshallah. Believing in the Islamic Foundation of Toronto's transparency policy, I'm just disclosing it today. We have never lagged behind in our accountability. Our financial statements, which are audited by a Canadian chartered accountant, are all in order up to December 31st, 2012. Anybody who wants to come and look at our accounts, you are most welcome. Please do not listen to any rumors in the community which is being circulated nowadays that there is something going on at Islamic Foundation. Alhamdulillah, in the last 6 years, I've been the president. There is nothing wrong. And I assure you, standing right here in the mihrab, that inshallah, we will be giving you the full accountability very soon. And inshallah, if anybody of you have any questions or concerns, please come to the majlis and we will be making sure that we take care of your concerns and we will provide you full satisfaction, inshallah. Thank you for your heartfelt gratitude to all my donors and the supporters who have always contributed financially and water support to Islamic Foundation of Toronto. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all in this world and the world hereafter. Ameen. If we at the masjid, the management or the staff, knowingly or unknowingly hurt anybody, we apologize and I ask for you for forgiveness. On behalf of the management of your masjid and your center, please accept our congratulations, greetings, and very warm wishes for a very happy Eid al Adha for you and your loved ones. It is an honor also at this time to acknowledge the presence of our own MPP, Mr. Bass Belkacem, who is here to meet and greet you after the Eid prayers. And I want to mention that in every time Islamic Foundation or any members of the community have approached him, he is always there to help us out. So inshallah, he will be wishing you happy Eid outside. Please enjoy your day and thank you for your patience for listening to me. Eid Mubarak to all of you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi. At this point, I'm requesting all the brothers who are in prayer hall, please stand and make your rows. So while I'm going to explain the Eid method in brief, inshallah, please fill up all the gaps in front of you or besides you. Do not leave any gap. So inshallah, we are going to pray 2 rakat Salatul Eid Wajib with 6 extra takbirat. So 3 extra takbirat will be recited inshallah in the first rakat and the other 3 inshallah in the second rakat. In first rakat, the 3 extra takbirat will be recited before Suratul Fatiha. And in the second rakah, these 3 extra takbirat will be recited after Surah Fatiha and the recitation of the Quran before going to ruku. So Imam will begin with Takbira Tahreema Allahu Akbar, and then we'll be reciting Sana Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika wa tabarakasmuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayruk, and then we will say three extra takbirat. So first Imam will say Allahu Akbar, we have to raise our hands and leave them free. Second time Allahu Akbar, raise our hands and leave them free. Third time Allahu Akbar, raise your hands and fold them. Then Imam will recite Suratul Fatiha and another surah, and the rest of the rakah will be the same as we pray normally. In the second rakah, Imam will recite Suratul Fatiha and the chapter of the Quran, and before going to ruku, we have to say three extra takbirat. Same method, we have to raise our hands and leave them free first time. The second time is the same. The third time is the same. And there will be fourth takbir, and that takbir will be for going to the ruku. And inshallah, rest of the salah will be the same. And after the salah, inshallah, the khutbah will be given. So all the brothers and sisters are requested to participate. And it is inshallah wajib to listen the khutbah. Jazakumullah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الحمد لله رب العالمين والآخرة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين اللهم إنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام تبارك يا ذا الجلال والإكرام سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين. اللهم اغفر لجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات، يا قاضي الحاجات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. الله أكبر، 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 الله أكبر. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونثني عليه الخير كله. من يهد الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة مبرأة من الشك والشرك والريب والنفاق، ونشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله وخيرته من خلقه وصفوته من رسله، بعثه الله بالهدى ودين الحق فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونسه الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده، صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اقتفى أثره واهتدى بهداه ودعا بدعوته إلى يوم الدين. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. أما بعد، فيا أيها المسلمون اتقوا الله تبارك وتعالى، فتقوى الله جماع كل خير وسياج من كل شر، اتقوه بفعل أوامره واجتناب نواهيه. إذا كنتم تنشدون خير الدنيا والآخرة وترمون السعادة والفلاح في العاجل والآجل، فعليكم بتقوى الله عز وجل. قال الله تبارك وتعالى: ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب، ومن يتق الله يجعل له من أمره يسرا، ومن يتق الله يكفر عنه سيئاته ويعظم له أجرا. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. عباد الله، من نعم الله على عباده أنه شرع لهم مواسم مباركة يفرح فيها الطائعون ويسر فيها المؤمنون، لما فيها من النفحات وتنزل الرحمات وكثرة البركات ورفعة الدرجات وتكفير السيئات. ومن هذه المواسم ما شرعه الله لعباده من الأعياد الشرعية التي تعود عليهم كل عام مرتين، وتتكرر عليهم بالخير والفضل والإحسان كل سنة في وقتين اثنين، في الفطر بعد رمضان وفي الأضحى بعد يوم عرفة. في الأعياد يظهر المسلمون شعائر دينهم ويتعارفون وتعالفون، وتسود بينهم حياة الصلة والمحبة والونام، ويجتمعون على ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى وتكبيره: الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. وإننا لنحمد الله سبحانه حق حمدي على ما من به علينا من إدراك عيد الأضحى المبارك، هذا العيد الذي يعود كل عام بخير وبركة على المسلمين عامة وعلى حجاج بيت الله الحرام خاصة، حيث يتقرب فيه الجميع إلى الله بأعمال جليلة وعبادات عظيمة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. أيها المؤمنون، اصبروا على ما أصابكم وتعاونوا على البر والتقوى، قوموا ببر الوالدين وصلة الأرحام والإحسان إلى الفقراء والأيتام، غضوا أبصاركم واحفظوا فروجكم وجوارحكم عن المحرمات. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد.
قال الله تبارك وتعالى ولا تنازعوا فتفشلوا ولا تنازعوا فتفشلوا وتذهب ريحكم واصبروا ان الله مع الصابرين بارك الله لي ولكم وفي القران العظيم ونفعني واياكم بهدي سيد المرسلين اقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم الجليل لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه انه هو الغفور الرحيم. الله أكبر 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 كبيرا الحمد لله كثيرا سبحان الله بكرة وأسيلا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي المتقين شهادة أرجو بها النجاة يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين ونشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله المبعوث بالهدى واليقين لينذر من كان حيًا ويحق القول على الكافرين صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد أيها المسلمون اتقوا الله تبارك وتعالى وأطيعوه وراقبوه ولا تعصوه واشكروا شكرا يوافي نعمه ويكافي مننه والهجو بالثناء والشكر لله جل وعلا أن بلغكم هذا اليوم العظيم وهذا الموسم الأغر الكريم واعلموا رحمكم الله أن يومكم هذا يوم مبارك رفع الله قدره وأعلى مكانه وأظهر فضله وسماه يوم الحج الأكبر وجعله عيدا للمسلمين. في هذا اليوم العظيم يتقرب المسلمون إلى ربهم بذبح ضحاياهم اتباعا لسنة الخليلين إبراهيم ومحمد صلى الله عليهما وسلم فقد أمر الله خليله إبراهيم عليه السلام بذبح ابنه وفلزة كبده فامتثل وسلم لكن الله سبحانه بلطفه ورحمته فداهم بذبح عظيم فكانت سنة جارية وشرعة سارية عملها نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ورغب فيها ففي الصحيحين أنه عليه الصلاة والسلام ضحى بكبشين أملحين أقرنين ذبحهما بيده وسمى وكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. صلوا وسلموا رحمكم الله على نبي الرحمة والهدى كما أمركم بذلك ربكم جل وعلا فقال عز من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا وقدوتنا محمد بن عبد الله وارض اللهم عن خلفائه الراشدين وعن الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وأنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين وذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين. اللهم اجعل عيدنا سعيدا وعملنا صالحا رشيدا. اللهم أعد هذا العيد السعيد على الأمة الإسلامية وهي ترفل بثوب العز والنصر على الأعداء يا قوي يا عزيز. اللهم أقر أعيننا بإعادة المسجد الأقصى إلى بلاد المسلمين ونصرة إخواننا المجاهدين في أفغانستان وفي فلسطين وفي غيرها من بلاد المسلمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات وأصلح ذات بينهم واهدهم سبل السلام وجنبهم الفواحش والفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم حبب إليهم الإيمان وزينه في قلوبهم وكره إليهم الكفر والفسوق والعصيان. اللهم ولي على المسلمين في كل مكان خيارهم وأصلح قادتهم وعلماءهم وشبابهم ونساءهم يا رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. تقبل الله منك ومنكم صالح الأعمال وكل آمن ولأمة الإسلامية بكل خير وآخر دعوانا للحمد لله رب العالمين.